Okay, so in this video, I'm going to share with you a review of a typical blog structure and how it's normally laid out. All right, so let's get started. All right, so let's kind of navigate through this one that I have in front of us. It's called Video Workout Review, and you're going to have some things that are very common to most website blogs. First, you're going to have a title or a logo that's associated with the name of the website. You might have some social media icons that are on the top right, and you have these navigational bars. So this one has their top navigation bar, has all their disclaimer pages, terms of use, privacy policy, etc. And then they have a secondary navigational bar, which has their homepage and links to various pages throughout their website. And then on the left right here, they have the very top blog post as a what they consider this as a featured blog post. So that's like something that you want to bring to people's attention. It's the very first article that they see. And then you have other blog posts that go from newest to oldest going down. So you might have some images, a title of what the article is about, a brief excerpt so people can kind of get an idea of what the article is going to be about, and then usually a click to read more button so then they can kind of read more about the article. So I'm going to go ahead and show you what that looks like. So once they click through, they can basically read more about it. And as I mentioned, these are going to have older articles that are in sequential order right here. Then you're going to have basically a footer menu that might have some copyright information, maybe some links, and you can go from there. Also, things that you might see typically on a blog is a sidebar. So some things that people add on sidebars are, for example, they have some ads. They might have links to categories of your blog post, which I'll explain a little bit more later. And then they might have like a Facebook like box and some tags. So those are kind of the typical things that you're going to see with a blog layout. Now I'm going to show you some internal pages so you can kind of get an idea of what to expect. So here's an example of a page, and typically pages could be a full width page, or it could also have a sidebar as well. You have content, they can have videos, pictures, links, and also social media icons for people to share or comment, or a comment box for people to write comments about. And here's an example of a page that has a sidebar on it. So you can see right here, here's another page with some social media share buttons and your sidebar, and then the content on the left-hand side. So you're probably wondering, well, why is this laid out the way it is? Well, most people read left to right, so they want to put the content on the left-hand side. So, and then all the on the buttons on the sidebar, because most people are right-handed, so most of the buttons that are be able to clickable are on the right-hand side. That's usually why it's the most common sense to lay it out this way versus having the sidebar on the left-hand side, because then people will be reading all the sidebar content first, and if they want to click something, they have to scroll all the way across the page to the other side. So there's actually a reason why things are laid out the way they are. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and click on an article so you can kind of see what a typical blog post looks like. So obviously, like I mentioned, you can have your title, the date of when it was written, who it was written by, and some social media icons for you to share the article. There's pictures, links, and maybe an email subscription box, and then areas where people can comment. Okay, so I just want to give you another quick example of what another blog could look like with very similar structure. So let's go through it. So as you can see, this one has the title, it has some social media proof, and then it has a navigational bar just like the other one. And it's also laid out very similar, except for these pictures are a lot wider. And then they have sidebar icons or advertisements, so you can get your email subscription. They probably have some links to popular articles. And then similar fashion, you can read a little bit about the article and then click more to read to get some more information. So as you can see, there's just you know, they have the same thing. They have the title, the name of who it was written by, how it was categorized, some social media icons, and then pictures and about the article. And as you scroll down, you get to the very bottom. There's other links to other articles and also comments. So I'm going to show you how to create a blog in the next couple videos.